welcome to another Blackpool Pleasure Beach vlog. Of course, if you haven't already, make sure you do check out the Alton Towers one, which has been uploaded a few weeks ago. So today, I'm outside Valhalla. Of course, as we know, it's what was supposed to open on the this year, 2022. But obviously, with Pleasure Beach's media sites, they're not really that good at communication, so that's why I decided to come over here first. And then, because I don't really like there being negative on vlogs, I really don't. So I thought, you know what, let's come over here, see what's going on. Because it has been a long time since I've done a Pleasure Beach vlog. So I'm going to spin you around and see what we can see, and then discuss it even further.
So here we are in outside the Valhalla.
One thing I really don't like, and people have been saying this, is just that up there. Give you a bit of a zoom in. So I don't know why the hell they've brought it down up. Is it because of ice blast next door and they don't want to see inside it? I don't have a clue why they've done that. And also, there's nothing much going on the outside, to be honest with you, apart from still the flame boards up, which should have come down this summer really. But now they say, now according to the website, it's still saying 2022, but are we going to see it in 2023? Well, obviously, I just don't know anymore, because I think everyone's decided to give up on the excitement of it. So I thought, look, I just had enough of this now. Just get it open, get people happy, and then just post on social media sites what the hell is going on. So this is what I don't like doing, this type of thing. While sat in the vlog, so you've got no information about it at all. Try go on Pleasure Beach's website, nothing at all. It's was that, oh yeah, it's getting reimagined. Yeah, you said that nearly a year ago, so I just don't know. But of course, what we can see is some little station work going on. Of course, it's a bit shaky. So a few years ago, we've never had these up, but I think this is a great idea to put them up. So that's a plus side. But it's just that I'll stop. I think what they have done, why have they done that? But I think, in my opinion, just put some theming on it. Maybe like, if it's late night riding, for instance, probably get a projector on. Valhalla, or some flames even, just put inside this building here, maybe somewhere up there, put a little projector on, obviously to cover it in rain season, but that is, that's just ridiculous. If I was the owner, I was like, nah, I'm not having that up. Unless they're keeping it up, is that for permanent reasons, or is that actually staying there? To me, that looks like that's literally nailed into the structure itself. But again, I'm not a clue. I don't know what's going on. If anyone knows, comment down below on why there's a massive board up there. But yeah. I'm just not happy about that, to be honest with you. I'm really not. But you know what? Should we just go and get on some rides? And take our minds off it. And then see what happens. Of course, it is a very sunny day in Pleasure Beach today. Surprisingly, because it's been raining for the last few days. So it's like, I hope the weather's decent as long as it actually is as well. Park is quite quiet. I've been told it is completely dead. Also, some work has been going on the Derby Racer as well. So I think we can just get a peek through here. Yeah, horses are still there. Everything's still up in there. But yeah. It's nice to see some work going on there in the Pleasure Beach, especially on Derby Racer. So, yeah, park hours today, it's 11 till 5. So,
Obviously, it's winter weekends. So, yeah. So, some action off the flying machines. Of course, what is next to the Pleasure Beach? Are they getting rid of a ride or what? Of course, that big blue one over there. I say get rid of it. Absolutely painful. Get rid. Great off ride, horrible on rides. There you go. So, right, let's get on some rides. Just had a ride there on the ghost train, couldn't remember the name of them. Yeah, definitely the ghost train that. But if you have been to Journey to Hell this year, you know they put some actors in there. So I thought, you know what, that's a great idea. Why don't you just put actors in the ghost train all season? So, firstly, I think that'll just make the ride better, to be honest. Yeah, it is a bit tame. Well, it's really not that great when you are on it. We've waited about 10 minutes for that to get on it. So it's not, operations are quite quick on it, to be honest, depending on how busy it is. I am going solo today, so we've got no Jess with me. So for Noah's come down, do a solo vlog, and then see how much we can get in. So that's making my way onto the river case. Now it's actually complete dead queue line. I'm literally not joking. How dead is the queue line? Seriously. It's the river case, it's a classic. Get on it. So obviously if you are coming down to Pleasure Beach, don't miss out on the river caves. It's a really good classic dark ride. So yeah. There's gonna be some online footage from the river caves. Not done this one for a bit. So here we are then on the river caves, a full boat to myself. So I'll pass some yellow. I'm not joking, a full boat to myself. Look, just turn you around. There you go. This one, no one behind me at all. How great is this? It's like it probably hired it. Probably hired river caves, why not? Because it was absolutely dead, that queue line. Oh, bloody hell, I'm getting wet. Ah! So yeah, I do love this classic dark ride. It'd be a shame to see it actually go, because we don't have that many water rides anymore in the UK. Of course, at the time of this recording, Great Yarmouth of Pleasure Beach have just announced that they are getting rid of their log flume. So that's another disappointment in the theme park industry. Well, seems to have some effects down here. Which is quite unusual, because you don't really get effects on the river caves. See, stuff like this, keep it on today, you can go far with it. Look, into the fog now, into the unknown. That was a bit soaky. What I do love to see is these fish actually move. Being animatronic, that would be quite a good effect. Along with these as well, instead of just staying still. Touches like that could go really far if they put their mind to it and spend the money. But no, Pleasure Beach don't like spending money. So that crocodile there, imagine the mouth moving on that. And I'm going to try it, that needs a bit of a touch up. That could be a little bit of work, not much. Bit of damage on the trunk and whatnot. Going quite fast actually, because I'm on my own. Now this is the room I do not like at all. Because I just find it boring. Yeah, nothing at all. Absolutely nothing. Oh, I see a bit of theming right in the middle there. Or at least something, because it's absolutely dead. Of course, you have got Wallace and Gromit above us. Depending on how loud the rocket is on the speaker, you'll be able to hear it. But if you are broken down on the Wallace and Gromit above, you do actually get to hear the river caves down below you. Because it used to be a gold mine type ride located at Wallace and Gromit now. Of course, we are heading into the Valley of the Kings. Decent, to be honest, today. of course, like I said, it is not, by the time we record, it's not the actual last day of this season. That's about 2 Sundays time. Of course, by the time this is over, probably be at the end of the season. So we have got plans for next year, so don't worry about no vlogs coming for a while. Of the art of ancient Egypt. Oh, I think these boats should need have new ones, have back crests. The only reason saying that is I'll show you in a minute. Because you have come onto the place before, you know what I mean. Going to the seven already.
On the sandstone cliff on the west bank of the Nile stand the temples of the Abusin. They remain unknown in the outside world.
Well, look, that's right. What affecting it, anyway? Well, 10 feet away from each other, would you say? So, now, this is why you need new boats with decent rubber backrests. You go on this lift, you're not leaning backwards. You've got to hold on. We should hold on for dear life here. Monkey in a barrel. See, the effects go really far on rides if they put their mind to it. Oh, here we go. See, more effects and then needs some more work doing to it. See, that's why you need back rests. Oh, flipping it. There we go. Good one, I'm sat in the middle. There you are, some more effect here now. Because these went on first time in the season. Oh, it's up now. So it's that that boat going through. So, yep. So yeah, them is making their way down now. Down the drop. Big drop. Oh, bloody hell. There we go. There's the river case.
So I've just had a ride on the river case just then. So yeah, that's a really good ride actually. You do go fast if you're on your own. But when you've got someone else with you, you do end up going slower and tipping the boat more forward. So making our way up to the ramp now. Of course, there's some work been going on the Big Dipper. Some retracking going on. Of course, there has been a rumour about another retrack on the big one, which does happen. But of course, looked at the vlog from the beginning of the season, and they mentioned a track where it needs going. Well, of course, I will spin the camera around for you right now. So then down to Big Dipper and Infusion. Looks like some maintenance is going on in Fusion on the water side of it. So yeah, basically, big one. So I don't know if you remember watching, go back to the video, it is on there. But I mentioned this bit here. Needs a bit of, I didn't know why they didn't do that retract, so apparently that's happening now, when the season closes. But I think Infusion here, I just think either get rid of it or just retrack the whole thing and paint it up a bit to make it slightly smoother. Because it looks great off-ride, but when you're on-ride, it's absolutely painful. Like I like to call it, headache the ride. So if you are coming, bring painkillers with you. Unfortunately, I've not got any with me, so I'm going to see how I get on with that. Because there was a bit of a queue down there. Give it a zoom in. Right into the station. So also, that's what Big Dipper has got a bit of a retract. Got some retract going on down at the back section. So of course we've got to get the Pleasure Beach Express down there. take a closer look, because it is Jesse's favourite woody here at the park. Of course, new lights as well on the structure, so the old ones. Well, I think obviously it is coming up to 100 years next year for Big Dipper. Well, I'd see some repaint going on, especially right at the top as well, where it's blue and white. So, yeah. Because it is kind of dead coming down to the south end of the park. Very dead, actually. Actually, it helps with anyway, you're vlogging with the sunshine. It's not like Alton Towers, but it was raining all day. So, yeah. Of course, big one going up now. Of course, get some off-ride shots on that. Of course, icon as well. This is how quiet the Pleasure Beach is to zoom in into the station. That is how quiet it is. Of course, Technic main queue line is just around the corner. Fairly quiet, it's about what? 10, 15 minutes? Would you say so? So we're going to head down to the south end of the park now and get some off-ride shots and some rides and see what's going on there.
So just down in the south end of the park now. So of course, a massive shout out to Tim, who does amazing job on the photography side of Pixolve. So yeah, I've just been past some food stalls just then. Some of them don't seem to be open for some reason, because it is really quiet, but it's kind of cold day as well. I'm just here in a hood. I've got the jacket in my bag, just in case I need it. But other than that, it seems to be alright. So I'm just going to have a look in Icon Shop, see if they've got any new merch. Also, of course, we will also check out Kiss Me Quick Shop as well down by the entrance before we end up leaving. Because you've got quite a while to go yet until park closes. So, quite a busiest queue here. Of course, they'll talk over the roller coaster. That's a tip for you. Of course, the busiest queue is the big one. It's slightly outside the gate, but not massively. So, yeah. Have a look in. There we go, just got a shot then. So yeah, just gonna have a look in Icon Shop and then see if they've got any new merch.
So here we are then inside the Icon Shop. Of course, you've got your ordinary t-shirts with all the information about the ride. Of course, you've got your deals as usual, 2 for $60 or $34.95 each. Still need to get that bag yet, because it is £20. Of course, you've got a season pass order, you do get that 10% off merch. I think that was the hoodie Jess wanted, with a zip in the middle, I can't remember. Of course, you got all your Enso. Still upcharge. Hopefully, they don't do an upcharge next year. It's a waste of time having an upcharge. Especially not how much you pay for to come into the park, you just not need upcharges. Of course, you've got your body warmers still in store. Of course, Icon on the back. Quite a good make, them as well. Get it. Bigatta. They're a good make. Waterproof. Of course, you got one in the red as well. Of course, you got that on the back. Of course, this one I've got. Quite warm, actually. Of course, not much winter stuff going on. Well, got bits of winter stuff, but not loads of it. Of course, we'll be checking inside the Kiss Me Quick in a bit as well. Here you are, dog lead, in case you've got a little small dog. Yeah, I've not got teddy bears as well. I think we've got one of them at home. Somewhere. So, yeah. Of course, all your basic information. Say he's taking it around the park and ask him to take it to reception at guest services if you are visiting for the day. Fridges as well. So I do like these water bottles because you can put hot drinks in it as well, which is ideal. Yeah, I do like to see some new merch next year, but can't see it unless they're already making it behind the scenes. I don't know. So yeah, that's pretty much. Oh, that's nice, embossed. But to be honest, it's not even embossed, it's just stuck on. Don't like that. So that's how it just comes off. A few ways it will just come off. Of course, you've got your Icon Nano coasters. Big one in Icon. So yeah, right. Yeah, get on some more rides. Oh, also, just nearly walked past, is an Icon tie. Wouldn't use that for work. Probably could actually, if you work in an office, probably get away with it. So, yeah, pins, key rings. Oh, they're new. Not seen them before. Lanyards, got so many lanyards, it's unreal. So, yeah, alright, let's get on some more rides. So here we are then on the Pleasure Beach Express. It's waiting for it to depart because I am on the back, which is, if you are coming, come down early so you can get to the back, because it used to go that way behind me, so now it just goes the other way round. It doesn't go backwards anymore. But of course, if you do want a great view, just come to the back. Of course, if you don't want to be near anyone, just this best place to be. So yeah, I thought I'd get myself a little coffee. It is a latte at the moment. Here's a tip for you. If you are coming Pleasure Beach and you've got so many bottles or cups like that, bring them in and they don't even charge for you. Didn't ask, no date whatsoever. So of course it has been washed so many times, as you can tell. So yeah, you're not really that bothered, to be honest. That's what I love them. It's being this with you, that's great. So what we're going to do now is wait till it sets off, and then I'll get you some off-ride shots of the coasters going round, and also that retract that is happening on Big Dipper. I believe it's happening at the back of the park, where you can't really go unless you are on the train, and then down the first drop as well. I think there's some work been going on there as well, so just have a quick look at that, and then get some shots of Icon and Infusion and some other flats as well. So I then just left the station here on the Pleasure Beach Express because I've got a Zampola Disco Avatar M Bender. Came throwing up on that one, there's no thank you ever again because you've got Rev. Apparently there's a rumour about that going, but I don't know how true that is. Because it is only a small footprint on that. I can't really see that going, to be honest with you. But here it comes. Because it's not going to get loads into there, I don't think. Just want to take care of the ambience of the park and whatnot. Got some retrack, some this season's retrack, still fresh. absolutely like to see some more paintwork going on here at the big one.
So, see you on the other side.
Here we are then on the Big Dipper. Of course, got some retract going on here. I just don't know how, because it is down at the far end that way. But yeah, of course, got a maintenance shed for infusion. So I can't just leave in now. I do like to see the whole of this being retracted, of course, and make it its original colours on the supports, like blue, brown and red. So there goes Icon. It's perfect for day for filming this as well. Of course, it is meant to be bad weather for the next few weeks, coming up to the end of the season. So yeah. I do like coming on the Pleasure Beach Express. Of course, you don't have to spend loads of money coming to Blackpool Pleasure Beach, to be honest. Just takes in the ambience. Oh, what a beauty. Oh, that's a bit squeaky. Of course, coming around into Infusion now. I think they were draining it out for maintenance. Before the season closes for winter. She's got a massive rat, massive snake there. Yeah, I don't know what happens to all the fish. I don't know if they get put somewhere or whatnot. Because I would like to see that Big Dipper sign get refurbed as well. Well, yeah, that sun is bright. Because I will be making my way onto the big one at some point today, hopefully. So I am trying to catch all the catch up as much footage as you can before the season closes. So I've just come around this way now. Of course, there's some work going on here. I don't know what's happening. Hopefully new development. So I would like to see all these things here have a touch up on. Just to make it better, to be honest. Because we've got Steeplechase, another Arrow classic. Of course, also Big Blue Hotel. So I don't think you just saw that shot then, that was some work going on down here. This is what I said, if you are coming on Pleasure Beach Express, don't miss this out. Of course you can see some work taking place here, because from the top there, and all the way down here. So that's why it's all shut. I wonder what this is going to feel like when it's open on this section. Of course we've got a big one as well. So if you do want to get away from the crowds, this is the best place. Because this way, like coming back, sitting like back of the train, you gotta go backwards as well. Especially coming through this section here now. So, oh, is it? That just needs cleaning up. Get a power washer out. Especially more theming as well. But I can't see him touching all this up, to be honest. Just can't see it.
course, if you do cut back a train, there you go. That's why you sit at the back of the train. Because it used to go that way, but now it's going this way, the way we're going now. I would like to see it go back the other way, its original route. So I've just had a ride on on the Pleasure Beach Express. Of course, we are now making our way over onto Wallace and Gromit, another indoor dark ride. I do like to see some more indoor dark rides around the UK, to be honest. You don't get much of them. It's like water rides, you don't really get much of them either, because they all end up going. Because the park can't always maintain them, to be honest. So yeah, so we go over on Wallace and Gromit. So we are going inside the Wallace and Gromit shop. So let's have a look at all their new, well, see if we've got any new merch in. Of course, we do move stuff around. Of course, you've got your cotton zip bag. Of course, your plushes in, whatnot. I think that door's meant to be shut, to be honest. Of course, you've got a candy floss. Hashtag too much sugar. Of course, you've got your plush toys as well. $14.95 plus discount on season pass. Yeah, not much stuff in Wallace and Gromit, to be honest.
So I've just had a ride on Wallace and Gromit. Like I said, it's not that much of a great ride. It's a bit tame. I'd like to see some more improvements happening with that. And also some work as well. Because I've noticed on one of the walls it was falling apart a bit. So I'd like to see some work having to go on that. Of course, the operator said to me, you can't film on ride, but most people have. But of course, if you do, of course, I will check out if I hopefully get a fun for those behind two guys that will want to film, really. But of course, yeah. So I make sure I'll get on my own slipper, as they like to call it, so that I can hopefully film. She said, yeah, put your camera away, we can't film due to CCTV. I say a lot of crap to that, because most rides you're allowed to film on, especially indoor dark rides such as the Ghost Train and River Caves, and also Grand Prix. So you can film on that, because that's happened before with me. So I have asked to film on that, I said yeah. But I think for filming, I think you're allowed to film on dark rides, on flat rides, but not like roller coasters, if you know what I mean. So, yeah. So I was trying, what I'm doing now is get on more rides and then see where it takes us from there. So here we are then, walking down Icon, Queue Line. So it's actually quite dead for an Icon queue line, to be on a Saturday. It's great, really. It needs just a complete walk on and make sure I'm good. Because they just fall downstairs, huh? And just get some load of off-ride shots. So, yeah, just loading the train up now. And then, what, it'll be about, what, 5 minutes? Wait for the front row, because this is how dead it is. Ready? On the top of the stairs, down to there. That is how dead Icon is. So let's go for a ride on Icon. Dare to ride. Thank you. just had a ride on Icon there just then. Of course, when it was, I don't think how well you heard it, but when it was going around the track, it was the wheels was making some squeaky noise. So I think that needs looking into as it was going around the middle section of the second launch. So yeah, I think that the operations were brilliant on that. Best time to, I say, go on Icon is lunchtime, so it has time for itself to warm up. Don't go during the first time of the day when it opens. Just wait a bit longer for it to completely warm up. Then you'll be able to tell the difference between morning and afternoon. So what I'm going to do now is probably get some food and get more shots of the quiet-ish Blackpool Pleasure Beach Park here in the sunshine. So we are then on Alice in Wonderland. Of course it is a Blackpool Pleasure Beach, another classic. But yeah, what I like to see is something actually happened to this ride. But obviously, Pleasure Beach don't like spending money apparently. But yeah, so here's some of on my footage of the ride itself. Of course, it's got loads of strong smell pods. Of course, I do advise not to bring a phone on here, just in case you end up dropping it like I did in one of the vlogs I've done. So that was quite funny. So I've got my little mate next to me here. Don't know how well you're going to see him. Oh, there you a bit odd. Of course, yeah, comment down below if you do think why you've used it. Oh, to be honest, I don't think it fits in with the ride, to be honest. I've got a golden ticket. Oh, that's echoey. Echo! Yeah, that's a bit echoey. Nothing but a pack of car, said Alice. There you go. Go back outside. So I've just had a nice ride on Alice in Wonderland. So it's just, like I did say, I don't get why they put the music into that ride. Really, A, it doesn't fit, and B, it's the wrong type of film. Of course, they've used China Chocolate Factory for all that. Of course, from the old version, which I'm not too keen on. I'd rather have the Johnny Depp version because everyone likes Johnny Depp. So yeah, so what I'll do now is try and get some more footage of the park, then see where that goes. Because sun has gone in now, so it has gone a bit chilly. So yeah. So yeah, I'm coming on into Infusion. I was stuttering, why the hell I do this ride? I really freaking don't. But see that behind me? I think that's a sign of retracking at the top. No, well, I said at the beginning of the season where it needs retracking. Could it be for that section here? So I think so, because if I turn spin you round, you can see all the scaffolding going, starting to go up. So I'm actually quite happy that this section is actually getting a retrack. I would like to see it come extending down to where that one is over there, and then up here, and then probably end up somewhere towards the turnaround section. So that's probably why they've took the water out. So like I said, I don't know why the hell I do this. I've not even got any painkillers. Headache the ride, that's what I like to call it. But got an actual back pain the ride, back break of the ride, and then infusion, headache the bloody ride. Well, let's go on. Wish me luck. Everyone else is the same. I wonder if you're the same. Come off infusion. Bloody hell, have I not got a headache? I have got a. My shoulders are killing me, head's killing me. But that is just the worst ride. That needs getting rid of. Either get rid of it or retrack it. Personally, retrack it. It's that flame painful. Basically, my shoulder, it is so sore. It's unbelievable how sore it is. It's like. To be honest, that's just a one-way trip. So, yeah. If you ever see me go on infusion again, just tell me no. Because that is just the worst ride ever. It's like, I can't even feel my right-hand shoulder. Is that sore? But anyway, on to the next one. I'll try to figure out which one to go on now. Because the park is dying out very slowly here in Blackpool. Of course, we've still got a few hours to go yet till park shuts. Of course, I don't think I'll be doing all the rides here in Pleasure Beach. Of course, you know what Pleasure Beach is like. You could,
you just basically know your way around the whole park upside down. So, yeah.
So here we go then on the fire machines. Of course, if you are paddling this way. Oh, there you go, some new Valhalla signage. So we're on top of the ferry to go onto the building itself. So I'm actually quite happy it's now opening in next year. But I'm hoping April time, maybe May, into the start of summer 2023. So yeah, there you go. All the boy, I was windy a bit. Oh god. Oh my god, I am tilting. Yeah, but there's go. So yeah, there you go. So I hope I can see that. Maybe if you're quick enough, you can pause the video and have a proper look. So, yeah. Because it is very windy on the top of the flying machines. Of course, the inside building is nearly done, as I'm told. So, it's just the outside now. So I've been told the operator's box is in position, ready to go. I believe the new boats have been reimagined as well. So yeah, so let's hope 2023 is going to be about how many year without any delays landed in this year. So yeah, so we're panning round. So yeah, we are, I've got a coffee. Bloody hell, it's freezing up here. So yeah, it's very cold up here at the moment. It's starting to get dark, so this is going to be my last ride of the night now. Then we'll wrap up the vlog. Then, yeah.
So yeah, then making our way into Kiss Me Quick. Of course, we got some Valhalla merch. Of course, we got some socks as well, some Pleasure Beach Funshine socks icon as well. Of course, Pleasure Beach did announce that they have got a clock wheel. Well, they're nice. Coffee cup, as I'm a massive coffee addict, for those people who wanted to know. If you got your notebook as well. Of course, you're some of your winter stuff. Of course, you got your signs as well. No entry in one way. Of course, you got a dodging wheel. It's nice to see put signs out saying all parks may contain oil. Of course, the Pleasure Beach website does need a bit of an update, to be honest. So it's not a great site to find stuff on, in my opinion. Yeah, this is what we've got all. We've got one of these on. Of course, all these bloody sweets and crap. Because I don't think kids need any of that, do you? There you go. Heart plaque. £6.95. So I hope this does stay out for next year, so you can look into the flying machines or the mechanical side of it. Of course, your necklace, bracelets, necklaces. Of course, all your Journey to Hell freak nights. Of course, that hut display is from last year. Is that from last year? Yeah, that's from last year, that one. Got that somewhere. Of course, your icon hoodie as well, embossed, proper stitching. That is. That's not coming off for years. That.
It's going to be open next year.
So, yeah. Got a sort of small tailors as well. Sunglasses. In case you are going abroad for winter or anything. Snow globes. So I wouldn't mind having a little snow globe. Now we're talking. Mugs. Yay, that's what I want. Could have seen these in the shop. Of course, these are proper embossed. Tell you the blue words out then. Because you got your big sunshine cup. Tanker. Or the Valhalla and Wallace and Gromit. AKA on Wallace and Gromit. AKA get it refurbed. Little snow globes as well. Of course, your little travel cups. Of course, if you add a season pass holder, you do get 10% off. 10 pound that. Cushion old books. Kids activity zone. WG beans coffee. There you are, sort of merch inside the Kiss Me Quick. Oh, of course, you've got some hot ice stuff as well. Dragon fire.
See you later.
So, yeah. So, your merch from here inside Kiss Me Quick. So, there we go. Then, that has come to an end here at Blackpool Pleasure Beach. Of course, I had a really good day. So, yeah. I hope you guys have enjoyed today's vlog. Because, come Pleasure Beach all the time, in my opinion, there's not much to vlog about due to Valhalla opening. That's why I stood here, so I can get it in the shop. So, yeah, comment down below if you'd like to see more solo vlogs in a future time. And then, yeah. Also, comment down below what you'd like to see Blackpool Pleasure Beach have next. Personally, I'd like to see him have another water ride. Just, obviously, with that many water theme parks in the UK now, not really getting much water rides. Of course, get rid of Infusion, turn it into a Mack water coaster. Of course, like you've got Europe, like, in Europe parks as well. So, yeah. So the next vlog is gonna be in Manchester, at Heaton Park for Lightopia. Of course, Jess is coming along with that as well. So that will be right at the beginning of the year. So, of course, comment down below what you'd like to see next in vlogs, because we have got loads coming up next year. Of course, this is the last one of 2022 before we head into the new year. So yeah, I hope you all enjoyed it. Make sure you check out me Alton Towers one that has been uploaded a few weeks ago, about four weeks now. By the time this is uploaded, then. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe and show your support for me channel, really. And then, yeah. So, thanks for watching. See you on the next video.